Hello, and welcome to day 13 of the Equestrian Fitness Challenge. My name is Emma Jane, and I am thrilled to be bringing this challenge along with my sister Lorna in stridesforsuccess.com. If you would like to follow me on Instagram, you can find me at Emma_Jane_Leeson, L-E-E-S-O-N. So we're going to get straight into it here. We're going to close down the eyes, come into a nice seated position on the floor, cross-legged if you can. Maybe you find yourself in a little blanket if this isn't too comfortable to begin with, but just sitting down on the floor, closing down the eyes, opening up the palms so we can receive some divine wisdom and insight. And beginning by taking a nice deep breath in through the nose. And letting it all out through the mouth. Another deep breath in through the nose. And letting it all out through the mouth. And then finally, you know the score at this stage, the deepest one you've taken all day, in through the nose. Letting it all out. And just taking a breath or two here to just quiet the mind. And open the eyelashes, giving yourself a big smile, and coming to sit in a nice, really comfortable cross-legged position, looping the shoulders back straight away as if we're sitting up against a wall. And we're going to straight away begin by bringing the right hand to the left knee and swimming the left arm around behind us into a lovely little twist. So just taking two nice inhale and exhales here. Coming back to center and swapping over. So left hand to right knee, swimming the right arm around behind and coming to look over the right shoulder. And coming back to center. Putting the two hands on the knees, we're going to work through a seated cat-cow to begin today. So on the inhale, just bringing the chest forward, opening up, lifting up the head, and then exhaling, using the knees for support as you round back through the spine and bring the chin down to the chest. So inhaling, rotating forward. Exhaling, rounding through the spine, and letting it all out. Inhaling, coming forward. And exhaling, all the way back. And just two more in this lovely seated cat-cow. Inhaling to come forward. Exhaling to go back. And one final, really kind of flexing out through the spine here, coming forward into seated cow. And then rotating around to a nice cat. And coming back to center. So we're going to bring the right knee up in front of us here. We're going to bring the hands together at the heart, hook in the elbow behind that right knee, and just again, a nice little twist around to the left-hand side, using the elbow, pushing off the knee as support. Coming back to center, bringing down the left leg, bringing up the right, hands together, and again, just using the elbow to hook in. Lovely twist again to the right. And coming back to center once more. So we're going to roll down onto our backs now. Just coming down here, we're bringing the knees in for a little cuddle to begin with. A little bit of a rock. Just bringing movement into the body. And then we're going to bring the two legs up together, straightening them out if it's nice to do so. If you have a strap or a lead rope, you can strap on here just for a little bit of support. But just, this is so good, by the way, to actually physically go and put the legs up against the wall, especially if you're kind of finding you might be stressing out about something or freaking out just a little. Putting yourself into this position, letting the blood flow back down the legs, it's really good actually to just relax the mind. But we're going to start keeping the two legs up. We're going to drop down the right leg. So just bringing the right leg all the way down and then bringing it back up. Bringing the left leg all the way down and then rising it back up. Right leg again, all the way down and back up, and left leg down and back up. So you can, if you'd like, bring in the hands behind the head, making a little nest for the back of the head, using the thumbs to give your neck a little bit of a massage. Maybe lowering that left leg just a little bit here now. And then just with the right leg again, bringing it down, bringing it back up, and then left leg down and bringing it back up. So if you'd like to incorporate a little bit more into the practice, feel free that as we bring down that right leg, we're going to maybe just bring up the chest and the elbow towards that left knee. We don't have to bring that right leg down, sorry, the whole way, I should have said, just lengthening it out, let's say. Coming back up and then bringing the left elbow towards the right knee. And really syncing up with the breath then as we begin to rotate. Up and down, turning on the core, strengthening the bodies, bringing in the breath. We're only here for a few moments more. We count down from 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Bringing the head back down and letting the eggs slap down onto the earth. So straight away, just bringing the toes or the soles of the feet together. We're in this little diamond shape here. Bringing the soles of the feet together, letting the legs splay out. And again, bringing the hands back up underneath the head. So we're kind of mimicking this butterfly kind of wing effect we have going on in the knees from the kind of commoner. And with the hands, and just taking a nice restorative breath or two here and letting the abs just completely come to settle. Bringing in a bit of a neck massage with the thumbs, as always, if you'd like to as well. And releasing the hands and using them to bring the legs right the way back up together. Letting them splay out nice and long. Bringing the hands up and over for a nice full body stretch. When I say full body stretch, I really mean like reaching and pounding as much as you can, tensing up everything on the inhale, exhaling, releasing and letting it down, then inhaling again, pointing up, holding everything as fast as you can, tight as you can, and then exhale and letting it down, and then one final big massive inhale and really push and squeeze everything here. Face and bum included. And then exhaling, letting everything come back down. So we're going to then bring the right leg across over the left. Just bringing it over like this, or wherever it goes, wherever it's nice. So your right hip, and that should be right up off the floor at this stage. And bringing the arms out either full length, or if not, into this kind of cactus-y kind of pose. Bringing the right ear down to the earth, and just breathing into this beautiful supine twist here. So taking a nice breath or two. And then coming back to center, nice and gently, bringing the knees up, and then twisting over, and then the left leg go out over the right, and bring the left ear down to the earth. Listen to see if the heart is trying to whisper you any secrets. Mm-hmm. Coming back to center once more. And then just windshield wiping the legs. So literally bring the knees left to right. And each time you do, the feet are sliding slowly down the mat until they're fully stretched out. Bringing them maybe to the width of the mat, so they're just splaying out, letting the feet sprawl. And bringing the hands, maybe putting one on the heart, one on the belly. And just taking a nice few breaths here, corpse pose. Taking a moment here then, set yourself an intention for the day ahead. Bringing the hands then to the heart. Bowing the head slightly towards the hands and finishing with namaste. If you have the time, I absolutely encourage you to just spend a couple of minutes here. Just letting the body rejuvenate and relax. And I shall talk to you tomorrow for day 14. Slán.